Good morning, children. Hope you all are fine. Today, let's do the worksheet of the second chapter. All of you, please take page number 5 in your worksheet. Worksheet number 1. Read and answer. Here there is a small passage. We need to read this passage carefully and we have to answer the questions given below based on this passage. Okay? Bhuta and Harbir live in Amritsar in Punjab. Here we can see the names of two children, Bhuta and Harbir. Where do they live? They live in Amritsar. Amritsar is a city in Punjab. Amritsar is located near the India-Pakistan border. Okay? It is located near the India-Pakistan border. It is a city in Punjab. Amritsar is famous for the Golden Temple. The famous Golden Temple is situated in Amritsar. Okay, it is a place where Sikhs live in large numbers. Okay, the festival of Basant is very special for them. The festival of Basant is very special for them. Have you heard of this Basant? Basant is a festival celebrated on the first day of spring. Okay, it is a festival celebrated on the first day of spring. And it was very special for these two children. The kite flying competitions are held during this time. Another peculiarity about the festival of Basant is that the kite flying competitions are held during that time. It is a time when people fly kites. Bhuta and Harbir love flying kites. A huge fair is organized and beautiful kites are sold there. During this time, beautiful kites are sold. But Bhuta and Harbir like to make their own kites. But these children like to make their own kites. They did not want to buy kites. Instead, they make their own kites. 2 days before the festival, they buy colorful kite paper and strings. So, 2 days before the festival, these two children, Bhuta and Harbir, buy very colorful papers. They buy colorful papers and strings. For what? In order to make kites. They work very hard so that their kites look the best. On the day of the festival, Bhuta and Harbir wear yellow kurtas, which are dyed at home with turmeric powder. What do you mean by turmeric powder? Manjal podi. So, using the turmeric powder, they color their kurtas. They dye their kurtas and thus it becomes yellow colored. They wear these yellow kurtas on the day of the festival. Their mother prepares sweets and saffron rice for the puja. Bhuta and Harbir fly their kites all the day. Bhuta and Harbir fly their kites all day. The neighborhood echoes with the cheerful laughter of children and grown-ups. So, on that day, on the festival of Basant, it's a very cheerful day. People enjoy flying kites. We can hear the laughter of children and grown-ups. Okay? That day, the festival is very special for everyone, for both children and grown-ups. Okay, now read out the questions given below and try to answer them. First one, take the correct answers. 4 questions are given here. You have to take the correct option. Okay, you should take the correct answer. Bhuta and Harbir live in Dash. Where do these children live? Do they live in Amritsar or Chandigarh or Ludhiana? Where do they live? Please take the correct option. The kite flying competition is held during the festival of Dash. Take the correct answer. Bhuta and Harbir wear Dash on the day of the festival. Do they wear green kurtas, yellow kurtas or red kurtas? Please take the correct answer. Their mother prepares dash for the puja. Sweets and saffron rice, cake and pudding, sivain. Do this on yourself. Okay? Right, true or false? Buddha and Harbir don't like to fly kites. Is it true or false? It's false, no? Buddha and Harbir love flying kites. Okay. Then, so it is false. Similarly, try to find whether these sentences are true or false. They buy kites from the market. Do these children buy kites from the market? They wear blue kurtas. A huge fair is organized in the city. What do you mean by organized? Organized means conducted, held, arranged. Okay. Worksheet number 2. Word wise. Find the opposites of these words in the word search. We can see 6 words here. We need to find out the words opposite in meaning to these words. Okay. We should find out the antonyms of these words. We should also find the antonyms of these words here in this box. Okay. The words are hidden inside this box. Okay. First of all, let's see. What's opposite of close? Close opposite? What do you mean by close? Adakyuga. Then what's opposite of close? Open. Close opposite open. Open means torakuga. Laugh. Laugh means pottichirikkuka. What's opposite of laugh? Cry. Kariyuga. Cry. Near. Near means adutha. Near opposite? Far. Tall. Tall opposite? Tall means neelam koodiyathu. Height ulla. Tall opposite? Short. Height koranju. Okay, you might have heard sentences like, he's a tall boy. He's a short boy. My brother is taller than me. My sister is shorter than me. Okay. Then next, come. Come means variga. Then what do we say for povuga? Go. Come opposite, go. Bottom, taale. Then bottom opposite, top. Mugale. Okay. So close opposite open. Laugh opposite cry. Near opposite far. Tall opposite short. Come opposite go. Bottom opposite top. Now we need to find out these words inside this box. These words are hidden inside this box. You should find it out in this box. Please circle the words. Okay, please circle these words after finding them inside this box. Okay, I'll give you one example. One is cry. Okay, then open. Okay, I have given you 2 examples. You should do the rest on yourself. Okay, after completing it, please send me your answers. Then next question, match the pictures with the phrases. Closely observe these pictures. All of you, please closely observe these pictures and identify what these people are doing. Then you should match these pictures with the activities that they do. Okay, here we can see some activities given. You should match these pictures with the phrases given here. First picture. What do you see in the first picture? Girl is listening to music. So you can number it as 1. Second, you can see a small boy flying a kite. So the boy fly a kite. Then third one, the third picture, you can see a boy washing clothes. 3, you can number it as 3. Then a girl is cooking food. 4. Then the fifth picture, you can see a girl sleeping by hugging her teddy bear. So the fifth picture, the girl is sleeping soundly. Okay. Sukhamayittu urangunnu. Okay. So match the pictures with the phrases. You can number it as 4, 3, 1, 5, 2. Then next question. Circle the correct spelling in each set. Four set of words are given below. We need to circle the word with the correct spelling. Okay. One word is written with the correct spelling. All the other words are wrong. So we need to choose the right word, the word with the correct spelling. So first, in the case of first set of words, which is the correct one? Breeze, the second. Breeze, this is the correct one. Then, among the second set of words, the first one is correct. Then, tremble. Tremble means shiver. Then, third one, dragged. Which is the correct spelling? Dragged. Then, fourth one, skipped. This is the right one? This is the right one. Okay. All of you, please circle the correct words. Okay. Then you have to do one more thing. Please take your notebook and write each of these words 5 times. Okay. Write the words with the correct spelling. Okay. You need not write the incorrect words. Okay. Please write only the right words, the words with the correct spelling in your notebook. You should write each correct word 5 times. Okay. Write breeze 5 times, tremble 5 times. Okay. Similarly, you should write each of these 4 words 5 times in your notebook. You should send it to me. Worksheet number 3. Grammar. Add S, ES or IES to these words to make their plural forms. Children, we have already learned the rules of changing single nouns to plural nouns. I hope you are thorough with it. If you have any doubts regarding that, please watch that video once again. Okay? In the case of words ending with Y, we can change it into plural form by dropping the Y and adding IES. For example, in this first word, country, what is the plural of country? Countries. Okay. The case of words ending with Y, we can change it into plural by dropping this Y and adding IES. Similarly, in the case of words ending with S, X, Z, CH or SH, we can change them into plural by adding ES. Okay. So, the plural of bench is benches. Okay. In the case of other words, we can make them plural by adding yes. Now, can you complete this activity? Please try to answer these questions. We can discuss their answers during our evening session. Then, second one. Circle the correct plural forms of the words in capital letters. Here on the left side, we can see 5 words in capital letters. These words are in their singular form. What we need to do, we need to circle the correct plural forms of these words. Okay, we need to choose the correct plural forms of these words from the options given here. Okay. All these words end with the letters F and FE. Okay. These words end with either F or FE. And what is the rule that we learned about changing singular noun to plural noun? In the case of words ending with F or FE, we can change them into plural by dropping the F and FE and adding VES. Okay. In the case of words ending with F or FE, we can change them into plural by dropping F and FE and adding VES. For example, the first word, leaf. What's the plural of leaf? Leaves. We dropped the F and added VES. Okay? Plural of leaf is leaves. Now, complete the rest four on your own. Okay? Circle the correct plural forms from the options given here. Then, C. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of the nouns in brackets. Now we have to fill in these blanks by choosing the correct form of the nouns given in brackets. We can see a plural word and a singular word in each of these brackets. We have to choose either the singular form of the word or plural form of the word to fill these blanks to complete these sentences. First one. My father bought a new dash. The options given here are cars and car. How can we find the correct answer? See the sentence. My father bought a new. We use a in front of a singular noun. Okay, a denotes something singular. My father bought a new. So, we should write a singular noun here. Car. A is always used before a singular noun. So, my father bought a new car. Then, Neha loves to read dash. Neha loves to read books. There is no A here. There is no A written here. So, it means that we need to add a plural noun. Neha loves to read books. Neheke bookkalu vaikkan ishtamana. Then, third sentence. How many dash are there in your pencil box? How many dash? Which is the correct one? Pencil or pencils? How can we find the correct answer? Closely observe the sentence. How many dash are? See this R. R is always used after a plural noun. The word R is always used after a plural noun. So here we should write a plural word. So which is the right answer? Pencils. How many pencils are there in your pencil box? Then fourth sentence. The dash is sitting under the table. Cat or cats? Read the sentence once again. The dash is. When do we use is? Is is used after a singular noun. Is always used after a singular noun. R is used after a plural noun. Is used after a singular noun. So what will be the answer? Cat, the singular noun, cat. The cat is sitting under the table. Then, a rainbow has seven dash. A rainbow has seven colors. Why do we use colors? Because the sentence is not about a single color. It is about seven colors. The sentence mentions seven colors. A rainbow has seven colors. Seven is plural. So, you should use colors. Okay? I hope this is clear to you. Please complete these two activities. We can discuss their answers during our Google Meet session. Okay? Worksheet 4. Listening, speaking, writing. This worksheet is intended to improve your listening, speaking and writing skills. First one is a listening exercise. Listen to your teacher and number the pictures in the correct order. We can see six pictures here. Now, I will read out six sentences. Okay? Six sentences in relation to these pictures. Listen to me carefully and number these pictures in the correct order. Okay, the first one, the first sentence is Rohan is giving a gift to Neha. Rohan is giving a gift to Neha. Which is the picture related to that sentence? This one. In this picture, you can see a boy giving a gift to a girl. Rohan is giving a gift to Neha. So you can number this as one. Then second sentence. Some children are playing in the park. Some children are playing in the park. Which is the picture related to that sentence? You should number that picture as two. Okay? You should do it on your own. Third sentence. Mrs. Shah is feeding the birds. Mrs. Shah is feeding the birds. Find out the picture related to this sentence and number it as three. Then, fourth sentence. Raju is packing his school bag. Raju is packing his school bag. Fifth sentence. Suraj is working at the computer. Suraj is working at the computer. Sixth sentence. Jaya and Jeet are playing in the rain. Jaya and Jeet are playing in the rain. I hope you have numbered the pictures in the correct order. I will give you the answer in the evening. It's very simple. Then, second one, speaking. Work in pairs. Take turns to ask and answer questions about each other. What do you like doing in your free time or as a hobby? What games do you like to play? Do you like to read storybooks? Do you play any instrument? Do you play any musical instrument? Do you like to dance? See, during our evening class, I will make two of the children to do this activity. Okay? You can do this in pairs. You should ask your friend questions like, do you play any musical instrument? Do you like to dance? Okay? You may use words from the box. Okay, here you have got an example. You, do you like to play badminton? Partner, yes, I do. You can make similar questions using these words. Okay, for example, do you like to paint? Your partner can say, yes, I do. If you like to paint, you can say, yes, I do. If you don't like, then you can say, no, I don't. Okay. Similarly, you can ask questions like, do you like to play cricket? Do you like to read books? Do you like to play hide and seek? Do you like to learn piano? Do you like to draw pictures? Okay. I will ask you to do this activity during our evening class. Please be prepared. Then, the third one, writing. The little red kite was afraid to fly, but it successfully overcame its fear. Write a short paragraph about something that you were afraid to do but were able to achieve by trying again and again. We know that in our chapter, the little red kite was afraid to fly. It was afraid that it may fall on a thorn or a sharp bush and may get hurt. But eventually, at last, finally, what happened? It successfully overcame its fear. It succeeded in its attempt. At last, at the end of the story, we saw that the little red kite flew high up in the sky. Now, you have to write a short paragraph about something that you were afraid to do, but were able to achieve by trying again and again. You should write about something that you were afraid to do, but you could successfully do it after many attempts. Okay, can you write it? I will give you a model. This is an example. You can write this in your notebook. You should write an answer of your own also. You should write your own answer in addition to this model. Okay, you can write this in your notebook. You should write your own answer also. Last year, my teacher decided that we would enact a play for our annual day function. I was given the part of a rabbit and had to speak two sentences on stage. But I had stage fright. Every time I went on stage, I would not be able to say a word. My teacher and my friends encouraged me a lot, but still I would freeze as soon as I climbed onto the stage. One day, I was early for practice and no one had arrived. I climbed onto the stage and tried to say my lines. I was able to say them perfectly. I was so lost in saying my lines that I had not noticed my teacher and friends arrive. Everyone clapped for me and I no longer had any stage fright since that day. See? You can write a similar answer here, okay, in the blanks provided in your worksheet. Can you do this? Please write it on your own. When you finish writing the answers, please send it to me. If you have any doubts, just feel free to ask me, okay? That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.